The next thing we'd like to play for you is something that's brand new. A new oratorio entitled Billy the Mountain. This is the story of a mountain who gets rich and walks across America from California to New York and wrecks it. Then, when the government finds out, they send a superhero to take care of him. Remember that Billy the Mountain is shaped like this. He goes up like that, smoothed off a little bit on the top, like your father's haircut, down here on the shoulder, out like that, and then down. His foot's over here. In this hunch right there, there's a tree sticking up. The tree's name is Ethel. Ethel the tree is married to Billy the Mountain. Billy has two big caves for eyes, and he has a jaw, which is a cliff, and it sticks out like that. And whenever he talks, it goes up and down about 30 feet, and dust puffs out, going poo like that, and boulders hack up all over the place. Studebaker Hawk is a completely different story, however. I won't tell you anything about his personality until later in the song. We want it to be a big surprise for you now. The overture to Billy the Mountain.
Billy the Mountain.
Lincoln Continental.
Honk, honk.
And he laid a huge bulging envelope right at the corner of Billy the Mountain, right where his foot was supposed to be. Now, Billy the Mountain couldn't believe it. All of those postcards he'd posed for all of those years, and finally now, at last, his royalties. The mountain was rich. Yes, his eyeball caves widened in amazement. His cliff, which was his jaw, dropped 30 feet. A bunch of dust puffed out. Rocks and boulders were everywhere. They hacked up, crushing the Lincoln. Now, the man in the checkered suit, you all remember him? Well, he went screaming off into the desert. Yes, at sunset. All the way to Rosamond to get a beer and tell everybody there what had happened to his car.
I gave him the money. He acted real funny. He honked up a rocket. It totaled my car.
by 2 o'clock, the bars had already closed down, and Billy had already broken the big news to Ethel. With dust and boulders everywhere, Billy, choked with excitement, announced to Ethel,
"Ethel, we're going on a vacation."
Yes! And they were going on a vacation. Well, Ethel, you know, just like a woman, Ethel, she was excited. She creaked a little bit. And some old birds flew off of her. Billy told Ethel they were going to... They were going to New York!
Ethel, we're going to...
across the Mojave Desert, their voices echoing through the canyons of your mind.
Ethel, wanna get a cup of coffee?
Howard Johnson's.
Wanna eat some clams?
The first noteworthy piece of real estate they destroyed was Edwards Air Force Base.
And to this very day, wing nuts and data reduction clerks alike speak in reverent whispers about that fateful night when test stand number one and the rocket sled itself got lunged by a famous mountain and his small wooden wife.
Goodbye to Las Vegas, farewell to the lounges. We pulled a few handles, we drank a few beers. Chug-a-lug-a-lug. Guess that George Putnam should be on the air.
Just into the KTTV news service. Undeniably links this mountain and his wife to drug abuse and payoffs as part of a San Joaquin Valley smut ring. However, we can assure parents in the Southern California area that a recent narcotics crackdown in Torrance, Hawthorne, and Lomita will provide the secret evidence the Palmdale grand jury has needed to seek a criminal indictment and pave the way for stiffer legislation, increased federal aid, and avert a crippling strike of bartenders and veterinarians throughout the Inland Empire. But it is this reporter's opinion that Ethel is a former communist.
Within the week, Jerry Lewis had hosted a telethon.
La, 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 nice lady.
To raise funds for the injured.
Injured.
And homeless.
Homeless.
As Billy had just leveled it.
And a few miles right outside of town, Billy caused a,
oh my papa,
in the earth's crust, right over the secret underground dumps, where they keep the
pools of old poison gas and obsolete germs.
Sucking up two-thirds of it! For untimely dispersal over vast stretches of...
the Midwest!
Yes, now, and it was about this time that Billy received his notice to report for his induction physical. Now, Ethel said she wasn't gonna let him go.
I'm not gonna let you go, Billy!
And George Putnam, the right-wing radical fascist newscaster from Los Angeles, said,
take it away, George Putnam, the radical right-wing fascist newscaster from Los Angeles.
We now have confirmed reports from an informed Orange County minister that Ethel is still an active communist. And it is this reporter's opinion that she also practices witchcraft.
It was about this time that the telephone rang in the secret briefcase belonging to the one mortal man who might be able to stop all of this senseless destruction and save America herself. That man was Studebaker Hawk. A giant among men. Some people say he might have even come from Harrisburg, Pennsylvania. We're not sure. But if that gives you any indication of what sort of a person he was, then the rest of this stuff shouldn't be too much of a surprise for you.
Now some men say he looked like Alice Cooper.
Alice Cooper.
Others say, you're full of shit, man. He was born next to the frozen beef pies at the A&B. Still others say, nonsense, and again, my friend, he's just a crazy Italian who drove a red car. You see, nobody really knows for sure because he was so mysterious.
Or if he has a son named Pinocchio or what.
Some men say he could fly, some men say he could swim, others say he could sing like Neil Sedaka. What? All the girls in Flushing would be amazed at him. 2, 3,
amazed of you.
Thank you.
secret briefcase. A strong masculine hand with a wrist rod and flexi bracelets. Grabbed it
and answered in a deep, calmly assured voice.
Yes, this is he. A mountain with a tree going off of his shoulder? You're full of shit, man. What the? You on acid or something? This is really interesting. Let me write this down. Sort of take a few notes here. To New York? Causing untold destruction?
My baby!
Wanted for draft evasion? Can I fly there immediately and reason with him? An expense account? And per diem too?
Say he could dance.
The Studebaker Hawk Dancing Lesson and Cosmic Prayer for Guidance featuring Ainsley Dunbar. Hey!
Twirly, 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 hey! Right hand from the heart, top. Left hand from the heart, top. Right hand from the heart, top. Left hand from the left shoulder to the heart.
Twirly, 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 hey!
Obviously, only a person who could dance like that is capable of dealing with a mountain. Studebaker Hawk was so unique, some people even believed that he could write the Lord's Prayer on the head of a pin.
Some men say he could write the Lord's Prayer on the head of a pin. Head of a pin.
Three dog night.
Others still maintain the fact.
Good God.
He was born next to the frozen beef pies. And that was the main influence on him.
Some people believe he was born next to the frozen beef pies, and that was the biggest thing in his life. Yuck, yuck.
Boldly springing into action, he phoned his wife,
who ran a modeling school, whereupon he ran around the back of Gimbel's to see if he could find himself some big, large cardboard boxes. After which, he hit up the local AMP for some Kaiser broiler foil, some Aunt Jemima syrup, and a pair of blunt scissors. Yes, and in the parking lot of that AMP, in between a pair of customized bikes, where nobody was looking, he cut himself out a pair of really nice wings, and he covered them thoroughly with foil. Thoroughly with foil. Thoroughly with foil.
One more time.
Thoroughly with foil everywhere.
Then he wedged one under each of his powerful arms and sneaked into the telephone booth.
Now he closed the fucking door. He closed the door. And then he pulled gray denim, policeman type pants. And he spread even amounts of Aunt Jemima syrup all over the inside of his legs. Oh, God.
Soon, the booth was filling with flies. He held open the legs of his boxer shorts so they could all get in.
And when each and every one of those little cocksucking flies that flew up inside his Valentine print boxer shorts, he put his head between his legs and he said to the little flies in a clear, impressive voice,
New York!
And the booth
and everything
lifted up
out of the parking lot
and into the sky!
Studebaker honk!
Yeah, yeah!
Studebaker honk!
Studebaker honk!
Studebaker honk!
Yeah, yeah!
Studebaker honk!
Studebaker honk!
He's putting his legs with
Aunt Jemima syrup up and down.
His shorts will be filled with flies
that will be buzzing all around.
Studebaker Hawk, he's really out of sight.
Studebaker
Hawk, he does it every
night.
Studebaker Hawk,
he treats them
buzz all right.
Studebaker Hawk,
that's why they never bite.
Hey!
He's in the
eye!
Light in the
eye! He could be a
frog or a lesbian queen.
Light in the eye!
He could be a
Might be able to stop all of this senseless destruction was Studebaker Hawk. Tonight. Good night. Thank you. Make yourselves comfortable.